How are you doing, Kanika?
How are you? I'm good. How are you doing? So good to see a new face.
How is lockdown treating you? Can you
See,
hear
like
me?
everyone else, it's a mixed bag, you know, trying to keep yourself engaged creatively, in a correct space of mind, and a lot of cooking is something that's going on during these quarantine days.
And a lot of writing also.
Well, no. I've realized that for the past like 20 days, I've been trying to cook vegetables and I'm burning them left, right, and center. So, cooking stories is like completely on the back burner.
Okay, so guys, let me tell you, Kanika started off as an intern at Red Chili's, and now here she is writing scripts and making such movies. Tell me, how has the journey been from being an intern to being a script writer?
Starting from the intern bit of it, you know, it was fun. I just finished a degree from London School of Economics, and just when everybody was thinking that here I am going to announce my next big corporate job with an amazing salary and you know chart out my future plans with a major multinational company, I took a flight back and came to Bombay on the pretext of writing my thesis. That in 2 months I will finish my thesis and then you know I can tell you about my future plans. And that's when I decided that you know I'm going to stay back and intern because writing films and becoming a professional writer was something that I had in mind since I was 17. It's just that I made a deal with my parents that I will finish my education first and get all my degrees, and then as for them, if I still was mad enough to kind of wanting to pursue this as a career, then maybe we'll have a chat then. So in my head, I had like finished my end of the deal. My degree was almost over. So here I was in Mumbai. I started interning with Red Chillies, and I had these grand plans of getting to know about cinema, about the medium of filmmaking, these beautiful, amazing chats, dissecting scenes, you know, everything that one hopeful intern would want to know. And trust me, for the first 4 months, I was just making printouts and getting coffee. It was very clear that I wanted to write. I enjoyed writing. I wanted to write films. I wanted to write books. And I was here to learn the medium. So that's what I was focused on, and that's what I did. And so on and so forth. I wrote my first book, Bombay Duck is a Fish, while I was still an assistant. Then moved on, and then I started operating as an independent screenplay writer. Manmarziyam was my first independent work, followed by Kedarnath, Judgmental Hai Kya, Guilty. Have you guys caught Guilty on Netflix yet? If not, please do. And yes, now my next one is Haseen Dil Ruba, which stars Tapsee Pannu and Vikrant Massey, and we've almost shot like 85% of it. And yeah, we're hoping that once things go back to normal, we'll shoot the rest of it. And
Do you remember the first time you met Shah Rukh Khan?
oh yeah. So for the first time when I met Shah Rukh, I think it was so Bobby was my immediate boss, Bobby Chawla. He was the executive producer with Red Chillies. So I think we were like a bunch of us, four of us. So I was the only girl. There were like three boys. They were in the creative department. I was a new intern, and so I think Shah Rukh had come to that office where we were working. So we'd already been told that Shah Rukh is going to be visiting, and he's going to be looking at a few things. And you know, we were working on some marketing campaign at that time. Everybody was like, just so I don't remember what it was, but I do remember. I was like, oh, so it's happening. So I'm like really going to see Shah Rukh Khan. So in fact, so usually like, given my history, I have a foot and mouth syndrome. Like I will definitely say the wrong thing at the wrong time. I will giggle when there's a funeral. I will stutter and stammer, and I completely like a flop show. And when I'm required to be my best and shine, that's how it is with me. In my head, I thought that you know I would tell him about my education and you know what I want to do, have a very impressive kind of a line to kind of present myself, but I was completely tongue-tied and like, Shah Rukh Khan. It was like literally just that. So I think I was just like a wallflower just looking at him from a distance. That's how it was, and nothing impressive that I could do or say or I didn't have a complete retard. But yeah, Shah Rukh was everything that one had imagined and more. So that's how it was. So I started off on a very quiet note. But eventually, you know, as one gained a bit of confidence and got over the starstruck, you know, that whole vibe of, okay, but he's also a man, so you have to also talk, and he's also your boss, so you have to deliver. So once you kind of get into the zone and then you start talking, then of course there's so much to learn, and you have to be, I remember, you know, with Shah Rukh, it's not that you can get away with faff, you need to know what you're saying. And you need to be on your toes. So that was a great experience.
Thank you for talking to us. Thank you, Kanika.
Thank you so much. Thank you.